You can use the Alan Cox Show After Hours line, or even if you listen to the show live, you can use it any time. 216-986-8903. You can hit us up at alancoxshow.com, of course. You want to watch, you can do it there. We got local talent in the Alan Cox Show Instagram Hotties. Volume 2 is up there.
Nice.
We've got...
lots of talent otherwise, too.
Yep. We've got drunk people doing stuff up there.
I posted a mashup of, check this out, Tool and Taylor Swift. You would think, no way this would work. And you listen to it, and you're like, wow.
You got chocolate in my peanut butter. You got peanut butter in my chocolate.
You got pop music in my metal. You got metal in my pop music.
Please. Punk rock, Bill.
Punk rock, yeah. I forgot Taylor Swift is definitely punk
rock. Stink Fist, We Are Never Getting Back Together.
Mm-hmm.
You think this would make Maynard angry, or do you think he'd...
I think he might actually dig
be
it.
Be down with it. Okay.
Pretty well done.
You think it'll make Poundcake angry? He's a big T. Swift fan, isn't he? What is this trash?
That's Taylor Swift, Poundcake.
But what's the stuff behind
it? Don't call her trash.
She's not trash.
Do not call Lil T Swift trash.
Punk Tool trash?
Yeah, is this beat? Is this punk rock? I'd rather stick with my hot topic.
Did you see that Nikki Glaser had to apologize? No, didn't have to. She chose to apologize to Taylor Swift.
For what?
I guess she called her super skinny. She watched it. Taylor Swift's got that documentary.
I saw that too. I saw the trailer, and I almost...
The girls are trying not to body shame each other.
I almost felt bad for laughing at her when she cried in the bathroom. Almost.
Why almost?
Corey Roddick watched it and said it was great.
Really?
Yeah. I'm going to do a Flicks and Bill with him.
Wow. That Corey Roddick, he is an enigma wrapped in a riddle, wrapped in a mystery, that guy.
Wrapped in a lot of veins.
So is he a Taylor Swift fan, or
no,
he's
not
interested?
But he watched it and he's like, "Oh, this actually was very interesting." He was very.
She's probably a sweet girl.
Just very intrigued by it.
And Poundcake was laughing all the way through it.
10 years? I didn't see it.
I thought you said you laughed when she was in the bathroom.
No, I was laughing at when you were reading the story about how she cried in the bathroom over Jake Gyllenhaal not coming to her 21st birthday.
Oh, right.
Because that is funny. A 21-year-old girl crying, "Mom, I really wanted him to come to my birthday party."
Except she was famous. She wasn't some 21-year-old rando.
Yes, but that visual is funny to me. Her little ponytail rubbing up against the wall as she's sliding down. And she's just like, Jake Gyllenhaal.
Huh.
Yeah, I don't know why.
You do find humor in other people's pain. That's why he's a Trump fan.
Mm-hmm.
That's why he's got that Trump 2020. The cruelty is the point.
Yeah, I only find humor in my friend's pain.
Bill has to know someone intimately to find humor in them hating what's going on with
them. Well, I don't really have many friends, so I don't have to worry about that. So
Nor do I, but I don't find joy in other people's pain.
It's better than looking at my own.
Now that's funny. That is hilarious. Well, there you go. The Tool Taylor Swift mashup is at alancoxshow.com. Along with Throw Up Thursday, the guy at the baseball game who just slowly and copiously vomits onto his...
It's great.
...huge belly.
Mm-hmm. That's a tough one to watch.
It's like he's half asleep going through it and is covering his mouth to zero effect. And it's just slowly, it's like lava coming out of a mountain. It's seeping out of his mouth. Bits of hot dog.
My girlfriend doesn't like the Taylor Swift and Tool mashup. Can you play a little more of it, please?
Yeah, sure. Yeah. You're trying to create a problem for your girlfriend.
Mm-hmm. Let's get to the chorus.
Your girl is Team Tool or Team T-Swift?
Tool.
Getting back together. I don't know what's the matter with that.
I like it.
I got zero problems with
it. I like it a lot.
It's not like they're going to go on tour together.
No.
We can live vicariously through
like
whatever
those mashups.
These people are
it's
doing.
Not, you know, it's not better than the original, obviously, but Taylor Swift doing a little metal is fun. For the original version of Trouble, or Getting Back Together, whatever that dumb song's called. Is it titled We Are Never Getting Back Together?
We Are Never Getting Back Together, right? Isn't that her song about Jake Gyllenhaal?
No, Harry Styles. There's an array.
You know, I can't keep them straight. Mostly because I don't care.
I think she writes songs to remember.
Yeah. Okay, well, there you go. You know, Inspirato comes from a variety of sources.
Jake Gyllenhaal was the inspiration behind Teardrops on My Guitar, right?
Don't know that one. He says right, like I can correct him one way or the
Someone
other.
Someone that hates Taylor Swift a lot. You sure do know a lot of
her
songs.
I said I'm a fan of her music, but the artist itself, I don't like. I think she's fake, and she's trying to...
Who do you think's real?
But I just think that there, as soon as the cameras go off, she's like, all right, God damn it. Like, she turns into this major bitch. Like, I just
Are
think
there
that,
reports and, of that?
No.
There are zero reports of that.
No, she's nice.
I think you are uncomfortable with someone who is probably very nice, and so you're looking, you're creating a scenario in which she's not that way. You're saying, I think she's fake, because that makes you feel better.
Sure.
Because taking anyone at face value who might be genuinely nice, especially someone that wealthy and famous, makes you very uncomfortable.
Sure. Let's go with that.
I think that's true.
Okay.
Right?
That is your opinion.
Is that a correct opinion?
No.
It's not.
No.
So you laugh at her, why? You think she's fake, why?
I think she is a phony. I think.
But why? Well, you've already said that.
Based
why
on
do
what?
You think that?
Just by the way she acts. I've never met somebody that's just so prissy and perfect like that.
You never met her?
No, I never met her. But just from what I've there's enough footage of her behind the scenes, on stage.
But what I'm saying is you're seeing the same thing. I mean, a personal connection to someone notwithstanding, right? Since you don't have that with her. You're seeing the same thing everyone else is seeing.
Sure.
And so everyone else has not come to that conclusion.
A lot of people have. And she addresses that in the documentary.
Yeah.
But, I mean, that's fine.
You've really put
her.
A lot of thought in it.
I think you should watch the documentary.
I'm going to watch it tonight. Like I said, I don't like. I hope she changes my mind. I don't think she will, but to me, she seems like a giant cornball, and I think a lot of people are fooled by her.
But being a cornball is different than being fake.
I think she's fake. I think she's a cornball.
Being a cornball, by the way, not the worst thing that somebody can be.
No.
Being a cornball like is just being...
But
being overly
earnest.
I think she's
stuff,
highly overrated. Like, half the awards she has.
Well, that's
a
completely different thing, though.
No, I'm adding on to that. I'm not taking back anything I said about her. I'm adding on. I think she is highly overrated. And her albums, she's a good artist. And she's hella talented. But she's not all that. Like, she's not... For every award show that she has gone on, and every award that she's won, I'm sure a good three or four of those could have gone
award.
To someone else.
Yeah, of course. But that's any award.
Okay,
because
but
it's all,
I'm just telling you why I reasons
right.
why I don't
but,
dig her.
But that's why I don't. That's why I take awards out of it because they don't mean anything.
Okay, but also the publicity that she gets, I think it's only. She wrote another song about her ex-boyfriend. Okay, artists do that all the time. Why is it something with Taylor Swift? Because they have nothing else to talk about. Her being
everybody's telling me it sounds like Flyleaf. Do you remember Flyleaf?
Flyleaf.
Yes,
Taylor
I do.
Swift fronting Tool there sounds like Fly. They were like a Christian
so
band.
Sick. Nuh-uh.
I don't know that.
They were punk. I remember when they came out.
No, they were a Christian band.
If it's not pop, it's punk.
Right.
Flyleaf, they came out with a song called I'm So Sick.
Yes, they were. It had one hit. They were a Christian band. They tried to keep it under wraps because they didn't want to get pegged as that, but
gotcha.
They were. Like Skillet is a Christian band, but they don't like run around telling everyone that. They don't do worship festivals because they don't want to get pigeonholed. Alan, for a guy who knows virtually nothing about the music itself, Poundcake really knows all the gossip.
Yeah.
Does he subscribe to Tiger Beat?
What is that?
Do you subscribe to Tiger Beat?
So that's a no, because I don't even know what that
is. Right, that's a magazine, sir or madam.
No, but he watches Wendy Williams constantly and all these other gossip shows.
I've been around for the last 10 years, and I've just seen the news circulating around Taylor Swift. And when I watched Kanye West got up on stage and took away her award.
He didn't take away her award.
So
if you
watch the documentary,
what
would need to be in the documentary for you to revise your opinion?
I mean, I had my opinion changed on Hillary Clinton when she went on Howard Stern.
Well, Okay, so what would be in the documentary? Like, what could you envision where you go, oh, that's...
I don't know, because I don't know what to expect, because I, once again, I don't know her. But just from what I've seen, I don't mesh with her. So I don't know. I will watch, and...
But I think it's funny, though, because people will always change their opinions after they see a more personal side of someone, mm-hmm. which is a perfectly natural reaction. They're like, right. oh, once you get to know her, mm-hmm. then you realize. You're like, yeah, that's how everyone is.
And then you realize there's also a lot of marketing and publicists behind her. Because she's not just an artist, she's an industry for people. Like, she is a corporation, basically. So, of course, they're going to do everything they can to publicize what she does to sell more records.
Which I feel like is where the perceived phoniness might come in, too. Because you're like, look, I am responsible for a lot of people's livelihoods.
And it may not be her fault. But from what she's not somebody that I would hang out with. She doesn't look fun to me. She doesn't, her idea of fun, I feel like she would be like, oh, let's go for a walk in the park, or let's go mini golfing. I'm like, no, like, let's go let's go get lit. Like, I don't want to do the same. I can't see Taylor Swift hitting the bong. I just can't.
You don't have an image to protect.
Okay, and that's fair.
Yeah.
But
you just wouldn't want to hang out with her.
Everybody has, a private life, and a lot of pop stars, they hit the bong when no one's watching and paparazzi never catches them.
So it's all about hitting the bong?
No, I'm just saying, I want
to
see something.
You don't think she likes to party and dance and have a good time?
I want to see something edgy.
She's pushing 30, by the way.
So
she's not
what?
18 anymore. You've mentioned hitting the bong a couple of times. So she's probably
just
hit
of the
bong.
Something of the sort.
And what's edgy in pop music?
I don't know.
For a guy whose favorite punk band is Panic at the Disco, what exactly is edgy to you?
As much crap as I give Halsey,
talk about corny.
She's a little edgy. I can at least give it to her. She may have mustard vagina, but at least she looks a little edgy.
Yeah, I don't get it.
Okay.
I don't know. A tattoo. Maybe she did something.
A tattoo.
Maybe get a motorcycle.
Tattoos are hardly edgy.
I don't know.
Everybody's got them. I'm more edgy because I don't have any tattoos.
You can't ask me, why I don't mesh with the person.
Can.
But I tell you, just from what I saw of her, I don't like. I explained to you why.
You haven't actually given us any real reasons, it seems like.
Well, forget.
But I don't have to like someone.
Right.
I never
said
you had
to.
No.
I'm not.
Listen, here's the thing.
Jesus.
Here's what I'm trying to get to. I fully understand not liking someone. What I don't understand, it is a step beyond that to say, I laugh when they're upset.
It was the one
That's
time.
A different thing. Like, if I don't like somebody, I don't pay attention to them.
Right.
If there's an artist I don't like, I don't, hate like the, or you know what mm-hmm. I mean? People go, oh, I hate listen to that. I go, no, I ignore them.
Because
I don't like their material or their art or whatever. It's for other people who are not me. But when you say, I laugh thinking of her crying, that's a very different...
10 years ago.
So what? You're no different than you were 10 years ago.
Not true.
You're still laughing at other people's pain now. So clearly, you are no different. If you saw her cry in this documentary, you would laugh.
She does cry in this documentary.
Then
I saw
you'll
it in
laugh.
The trailer. I didn't cry.
10 years hence, you'll laugh. Won't you?
I guess we'll see you tonight.
Uh-huh.
I hit the pen. I'll see. I'll go into it with a clear mind and...
hit the pen?
Yeah,
so
edgy.
Yeah, real edgy. He's right. He's the one hitting the bong. Yeah. He wants her to hit the bong.
No, it's just... With Mary talks about Jack Black. She thinks that he's a cornball. She doesn't think he's funny. And
But she doesn't laugh like if his dog died, she probably wouldn't
laugh. No, she said she
would,
though.
Oh, she did.
Yeah,
oh.
She said she would. And also...
Poundcake's the edgiest one out of all of us.
Hey, right. I molest children.
It's pretty edgy.
That's very edgy. I don't quite understand that humor, but...
It's unnecessarily edgy.
Mm-hmm.
Trans people ruined everything. Well, no one wants to touch my vagina!
Do you have the new one yet?
Huh?
Do you have the new one?
No, I don't.
What new one?
Don't you worry about it.
Don't talk about me.
Huh?
Nothing.
I'm not talking about you.
He's talking for you.
That's right.
I'm with you. I don't get into that kind of hate liking things or hating whatever it is. It just, if I don't like something, I just ignore it. I like Kanye, and he's hardly in my life. The Kardashians.
He
not
also
my
doesn't
life.
Get radio play. Kanye doesn't get radio play.
I don't listen to the radio. I talk on it.
Yeah. When I'm at home, I don't want to feel like I'm at work.
The things that I like, she.
When you're working at McDonald's, you don't go home and fire up the grill, start flipping hamburgers.
I like watching The View. I like watching Wendy Williams, and she pops up in the news cycle, so I'm like, ugh, another Taylor
Good
Swift story.
Good thing, too. Boy, nothing fake about Wendy Williams.
Right. So real, that
Nothing
one.
Corny about her.
But she's edgy.
Edgy. She's got edges.
Okay. Whatever.
You like what you like.
I like what I like.
And that's fine. I'm just curious where you go down these other roads.
Figure out these the process.
What other roads?
Well, when they're in pain, it makes me laugh.
You're still hanging on to that.
These are your words.
I don't wish death upon her or anything like that. I laughed because she cried.
Well, I'm glad you're not being dramatic about it then. I don't wish death on her. No one said you wish death on anyone. You said... I laugh thinking of her sitting in a corner of her bathroom crying.
At 21 over with Jake Gyllenhaal.
What does that have to do with
anything?
Because you
got to put it in context. You're making it seem like it's so terrible. She was talking to a 32, 34-year-old man at 21. She wanted her to come to her house.
The context is that you are my chief petty officer. And it doesn't matter if she's 21 or 29.
Well, I don't care.
You would still laugh at her crying.
Screw her and her stupid ponytail, and I'm happy that she cried on her 21st birthday. I don't care.
And where did you put the ponytail in there, right?
I just imagine her, because she's corny, and she would have like a little ponytail with a stupid little, what do they have? A little scrunchie, and that's what she would wear to her birthday.
Yeah.
She's not wearing a scrunchie.
Hmm. All right. I mean, if you figure she was crying because she had her heart broken.
Whatever.
You cry in your car to Celine Dion.
Because I feel it.
Feel what?
I just feel the music.
If you, dear customer, ever happen to be in traffic and you're next to Poundcake when he's crying in his car, point and laugh.
They've already
Send me that video.
People have already seen me, so it's fine. That's why I stopped doing it at stoplights. I turn it all the way down so I don't feel it. Ever since that construction worker pointed me out and all his friends laughed at me, I
Oh, that would have been great if they caught that on
it
video.
It was right outside here, right on Rockside.
Yeah, I know where it's at. I'm just saying they should have videoed it.
Well, they were working. And they should have been working a lot harder instead of paying attention to me.
Alan, the only thing edgy about Wendy Williams is her jawline.
Ha ha. Ha, 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 ha.
I think, yeah. All right.
Plus all the D that I want, Taylor gets, and I don't like that neither.
Neither.
I think that's what it comes down to.
Too much Poundcake.
Way too much.
You're jealous that Taylor Swift
gets the famous D that he wants, and so he's going to laugh at her 21st birthday.
I didn't think Jake Gyllenhaal was your type.
Why would he not be my type?
I assume you don't have a type, or there is a type you don't. You like
Jake Gyllenhaal.
Twinks.
No, that's just what's around here, these Cleveland bottoms. But no, I would totally go to Hollywood and grab a Jake Gyllenhaal. Jarhead, oh yeah, I'll take me one. I'll take a Harry Styles, even though he probably has the foreskin. And the other guy she dated, what was his name?
John Mayer.
John Mayer.
Yeah, a John Mayer. I would take a John Mayer too. Mm-hmm.
Wow. Well, it's all coming into. Dare I say, clearer focus.
I'm going to watch it tonight. Is it on Netflix or is it Hulu?
Netflix.
Okay. I'll do it. I'll watch it tonight.
What's it called? Miss Americana?
Something like that.
Yeah. The Taylor Swift
documentary.
I'll
watch it tonight, too.
Yeah, something stupid like that.
I won't watch it, but I will trust that both of you will come in with specific opinions on it.
If I see one hair scrunchie, I'm turning it off.
If you see what?
A hair scrunchie.
A hair scrunchie.
I don't think she wears scrunchies, man.
What's your hang up with scrunchies, by the way? Were you molested outside of Claire's boutique?
No. I don't know why I hate scrunchies. I can't explain that either. I just do. I have very harsh feelings
towards
scrunchies.
That might be something to bring up in therapy.
Maybe.
Alan, why are you such a dick to Poundcake? Yeah, I'm the bad guy here. That's what
you
it
are.
Is.
You're
yeah.
terrible.
Yeah, I'm right. Well, it's my show. A, I can do whatever I want. B, I'm trying to drill into this kid's brain and figure out what's in there before I hit water.
Pushing me to like that white demon, Taylor Swift.
I don't need you to like anyone. I'm trying to get in there and figure out what's going on.
Well, newsflash,
and then
nothing
get
in there.
Out. All right, well, there you go.
Joke's on you. Keep digging and digging. You come up with nothing. Right. So who's the brainiac now?
Hit the water tank.
That's why we're addicted to them.
I contaminated the groundwater. I drilled too deeply.
Yeah.
All right. I'm jealous of him because I can't feel anything, Bill.
Yeah.
So I'm jealous of Poundcake crying in his car.
Maybe you just need to listen to more Celine Dion.
Maybe so. All right, hey, Nickelback. How about them? They're on the road. They're coming through this summer. Stone Temple Pilots opening. Not too bad. They'll play Blossom. I'll get choked up for that show if you want to go. 35192 to text. Next chance for you to grab yourself $1,000 is coming up at 5:30.
It's the Alan Cox Show on 100.7 WMMS. And everyone.